I think it's not so much about surfing, you know. When it gets to big waves, it's a lot about can you survive. You know, with practice, anyone can do anything in life. But it's whether you can go back and try again. You know, you don't. Obviously, nobody wants to choose something to die. You know, we're all gonna die eventually, but hopefully, it's not out of an action that we do repetitively. I've only been to Nazaré once, in October of 2013. There's a few different waves, and there's obviously the main break that's known as Nazaré, which is this wave outside. It's the beach break. I have been around big waves for 8 years now, and I've seen most, like a lot, and I don't remember seeing waves that big. Maybe ever before. My tow partner, his name is Carlos Bulli. He's the only guy I would have watching out for me in a day like that. A really big set came in and he started the ski and I started preparing. And when I let go of the rope, I thought, well, it's breaking already and it's very peaky. I'm gonna try and go a little bit further inside the wave. I just kept getting a lot of speed and the wave kept building and kept getting more and more crazy and bigger and faster, and on the third jump I just lost control of the speed. It was so fast. I mean, the only visual I really remember is being on my back and seeing the thing fold over me. That wave was okay, you know, I came up after a big hold down, but I was fine, and then I saw what was coming next, and I thought it was a big problem. There was nothing I could do, there was nothing Carlos could do. And I just had to take that wave on my head, and I wasn't really super psyched to take a wave that big on my head. That wave was a nightmare. It held me under forever, and when I got to the beach break, it didn't let me go up. I got a third wave underwater on top of me, right almost when I was breaking the surface, so I got all the impact. And then my life jacket got ripped off, and I went super deep. I didn't think I was gonna make it back up. I thought that was maybe possibly it. So I broke the surface eventually, and then that's when I realized I wasn't gonna last very long. You know, it's never nice to realize that you may die in a few minutes. I kept thinking that I was gonna explode against the cliff half alive, and that wasn't gonna be nice. Carlos came to pick me up twice, and on the second time we were so afraid that I was getting dragged to the cliff already half conscious that he told me to grab on the rope because that was the closest thing to me, and he dragged me underwater for maybe a couple more feet, three, I don't know how many feet, and then I was out. You know, it's not one thing that went wrong. It's not that I don't surf good enough and that's it. There's a lot of things that go wrong and you end up in a situation that you try and survive. That's basically it. You know, I saw a lot of people coming out and defending, and I had a lot of support. I think this one was a very divided opinion. It was very much some people, you know, like Laird and like others, didn't think I should be there, and other people thought, you know, that I was doing what I always did. It's more acceptable for a guy to die doing a crazy sport and pushing the limits and doing his thing than a woman, you know? And that's just how it is. We're dealing with something that we can die doing. And we all know that. I just think sometimes it's weird for people to realize that I actually know and I deal with it.